Did you know that in just a few steps, you can use the Census Bureau's Application Programming Interface, or API, to get results that look very similar to table downloads from data.census.gov? One of the nice features of the API is that it provides the flexibility to quickly get your results across a collection of geographies, such as all metropolitan areas or congressional districts in the United States. The process is as easy as tweaking an example URL, saving your results, and making a few quick edits in Excel. Let's see how it works. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to get data for an entire table from the American Community Survey. I'll walk through the steps using DP03 from the 2019 ACS one-year estimates for all metro areas. Before we get started, I'll show you a quick trick on data.census.gov to find the type of table that is associated with your table ID. We'll need this detail later. From the landing page of data.census.gov, type the table ID DP03 into the single search bar and press Enter. On the All Results page, click Tables in the upper left. Now we can see the table results for DP03. You can click the Product drop-down menu in the upper right of the screen to see the type of table in the results. In this case, we see data profiles. Now let's get started navigating the API by opening a new tab and going to census.gov/developers. We recommend using Google Chrome so you can see the API results in your web browser. My favorite way to navigate to our dataset is to click Available APIs on the left side of the page. Then we can scroll through our list of options. Here, I'll choose American Community Survey 1 year data. And now we can see some information about the different types of tables from the American Community Survey 1 year estimates. Scrolling down, we'll click into our desired year, such as 2019. Then we choose a type of table we're interested in getting data for, scrolling to the heading for data profiles. To get results for the entire table, we'll work off the first link labeled example call that has group in the URL. From the example URL, we can see it calls the API to get data from the 2019 American Community Survey 1 year estimates data profiles. It uses the group functionality to query all variable results from table DP02 at the national level. Select the first link and copy it. Then open a new tab and paste the link. Delete the portion that says %key=, your key goes here. Then press Enter. I like to press Enter between each step. That way, if we make a mistake, we know exactly where we went wrong. From here, we just need to edit the URL to change our table to DP03 and change the geographic level from the nation to all metropolitan areas. First, I'll edit the URL from DP02 to DP03, press Enter, and view our updated results. You can see how our list of variables have been updated to DP03. Next, we'll need to edit the geography. My favorite place to get this is to go back to my previous tab and click on the Examples and Supported Geography section under Data Profiles. This takes us to the API Discovery tool, which provides a list of variables, geographies, and other technical details needed to make API calls for this dataset. Right-click where it says Examples and open it in a new tab. This page provides a list of all of the different geographic areas compatible with the 2019 ACS 1 year data profiles and a variety of examples to fine-tune our results for each type of geography. For our example, I'll scroll down to where it says Metropolitan Statistical Area, Micropolitan Statistical Area on the left. Here we see two examples that look very similar, but you'll notice differences in the geography portion near the end of each URL. The one with a wildcard at the end, denoted by an asterisk, will give results for all metro areas. The second link, with the code 10420 at the end, provides results for a single metro area. In this example, the Akron, Ohio metro area. Since we want data for all metro areas, copy the first URL with the wildcard and paste it in a new tab. Then select and copy the geography portion at the end. & 4 equals metropolitan statistical area, micropolitan statistical area, : wildcard. Then go back to our other tab to continue to update our API call. Select the geography portion, & 4 equals US, and paste our copied text to change our results from the US to all metro areas, then press enter. Once the results have loaded, you can create your CSV file. Right-click the page and select Save As. We'll name this DP03 All Metro Micro Areas.csv. You must include the .csv at the end of the file name. Click the drop-down menu where it says JSON and change it to All Files. Then click Save. Use Microsoft Excel to open the file where you saved it. With just a few easy edits, we can create a clean view that looks similar to downloads from data.census.gov. First, we'll get rid of some of the special characters using Excel's Find and Replace functionality. In the upper right of the Home tab, click Find and Select, and then Replace. In the first box, we'll type in the open bracket. Leave the Replace With box blank, then click Replace All. From here, we can see it's found and deleted all 520 instances of the open bracket. Repeat this process for the closed bracket and for the quotes. Close out the Find and Replace box. Now let's find the geography labels and move them to the first column of our table results. Press Ctrl F to search the contents of this worksheet. Type name in the Find What box. This is the API variable that provides our geography labels. Press Enter and then close out the Find and Replace box. Notice Excel has navigated to the column for name. This column contains the labels for each metro and micro area in our API results. Let's move this to column A. Right-click column APF, choose Cut, scroll back to column A, right-click column A, and choose Insert Cut Cells. Now we see we have our geography labels in the first column for easy viewing. As a note, if you go through these steps and do not find any matches for name during your search in Excel, it means the name variable was not included as part of your API group call results. The good news is that you can manually add name as an additional variable for your API query, but we only recommend doing this in the rare instances when it is not automatically included in the group call results. This is because adding the variable this way often requires additional formatting steps that are covered in our other API video, using the API to get results for multiple estimates. The last step is to pull in the labels so that you know what each of the variables mean, such as DP03_0001E. I'll show you an easy trick to bring these in using the VLOOKUP function in Excel. Navigate back to our earlier page in the Discovery tool for our dataset. From here, click Variables. This provides a list of the variables for the ACS data profiles and the labels for them. To get this into Excel, follow these easy steps. Click into the address bar, delete .html from the end of the URL and press Enter. Once the results have loaded, right-click the page and select Save As. Add .csv to the end of the file name. Choose All Files from the drop-down menu. Then click Save and open the file. When you open the file, notice the first column provides names for all variables in the ACS data profiles, and the second column provides the corresponding variable labels. Just like before, we'll use Excel's Find and Replace functionality to remove special characters. Here, we'll run through those steps again quickly. Next, we need to copy and paste this data into our other spreadsheet. Click cell A1, press Ctrl A to select all contents of the table. Right-click the selected area and choose Copy. Navigate to the workbook DP03 All Metro Micro Areas. At the bottom of the workbook, click the plus sign next to DP03 All Metro Micro Areas to open a new worksheet. While we're clicked into cell A1, press Ctrl V to paste the content. Now click back on the first worksheet, DP03, All Metro Micro Areas. From here, we'll use a quick trick in Excel that allows us to easily match up the variable names and add the corresponding labels just below it using the VLOOKUP function. To start, right-click row 2 and select Insert. Click cell B2 and type equals VLOOKUP. Then type an open parenthesis. Click cell B1 and type a comma. This tells Excel that you want to find a match for DP03_0001E. Now we need to tell Excel where to look for this matching label. Click at the bottom where it says Sheet 1. Select all contents of the table. One method to do this is to click into cell A1. Press Ctrl-Shift right arrow and Ctrl-Shift down arrow. Then press the F4 button one time. This will lock down where Excel looks for the matching labels to the area we just selected. Next, click into the formula bar and type a comma. Enter the number 2 and type another comma. This tells Excel when it finds a match for the variable name, we want it to pull the content from the second column in this worksheet, column B. Then type 0 and a closed parenthesis. This tells Excel that we want to look for exact matches. Press Enter to complete the VLOOKUP function. Now we can expand cell B2 and see that it's found a match for DP03_0001E. And pulled the corresponding label of estimate, employment status, population, 16 years and over. While we're clicked into cell B2, locate the green box in the lower right corner of the cell. Drag the formula to the right of the table to apply it to other variable names. And now we have the labels associated with our API variable names. Each geography has its own row, and as we follow the row across, we can see all of the variables from DP03 for that geography. Having the data in this format makes it easy if we'd like to manipulate, sort, or map it. As a final note, one small difference between the CSV results from the API and data.census.gov downloads are the treatment of special values and the inclusion of additional columns to denote them. For example, when we scroll to column H for DP03_0001PM, the percent margin of error for the population 16 years and over, you can see the special values of -888,888,888. To get more information, view the corresponding columns that end in A to see the annotation for this particular variable. In this example, we see the annotation is right beside it in column I, with a variable name ending in PMA. Notice a special value of X appears in the annotation column, which means that the estimate is not applicable. In data.census.gov downloads, these special values are handled in a single column rather than being split across two separate columns, as they are when you request the data from the API. This is done in the API due to technical format requirements for ACS variables. We do some cleanup on our end during the data.census.gov download process to make the output more user-friendly. Depending on the ACS data year you are using in the API, these annotation columns that end in A may be intermingled with your API results, as they are in this example, or they may appear as a separate set of columns at the end of your results. If they are intermingled and you would like to learn about a quick trick to delete them, please see the PDF linked with this video. Finally, if you would like to explore the meaning for all special values, navigate back to the developer's page for your dataset. Under Related Information, click the Notes on ACS Estimate and Annotation Values. Then browse the table to learn more about special values, annotations, and their meanings. Thank you for tuning into this video. We hope you find this trick useful on how to get all results for an ACS table using the Census Data API.